Hey, what's up, you guys? Putting a hitch on your Lincoln Continental can take you to some pretty cool places. Come on, let's go ahead and break this hitch and install down.
You will need the tool seen here to complete this installation.
Okay, this hitch is going to have attachment points behind the bumper here and here, and underneath the bottom of the frame on the passenger side and on the driver's side. Our attachment points are well covered by the exhaust and underbody paneling, so we'll have to remove the underbody paneling and lower the exhaust. And it's going to be 10 screws down at the bottom here, and then two of the exhaust heat shield screws. Using a 7mm socket, get these screws lowered and out. Okay, and this is our 10th screw at the rear bumper fascia, lowering the underbody paneling. Once we get this guy out of place, we'll go ahead and switch our socket over to a 10mm. Okay, now we'll just pull this down all the way. Okay, lowering the heat shield, we can see that there's a lock washer here holding the underbody paneling in place. To get this off, we're just gonna unscrew it like you would a nut. You can use needle nose pliers or just two pointed ends to go in that hole, and then unscrew. There it is. We can go ahead and just pull down on this underbody paneling. It should all come right out. This exhaust system is pretty heavy, so we're gonna go ahead and secure it to, the sway bar down here with a strap. That way when we go to lower it, it doesn't damage anything or hurt anyone. Okay, next step is going to be removing the rubber isolators from the exhaust rod. Looks like we have four of them. One here, one up here. Open this area, and one right here. I'm going to go ahead and use exhaust pliers to get those down. I'll be using some soapy water as well to help it come off the exhaust rod. Rear one, move up to the forward one here. Okay, we'll put our soapy water on there to help it come off the rod. Okay, my strap is holding good, so now we'll go ahead and, the exhaust tip is coming through this chrome bumper trim here. It's getting caught on it from lowering all the way down that to give us enough room to attach the hitch. So what I'm going to do is remove this exhaust trim here. That's going to be four screws up behind on top and around the sides here. We're only going to be taking out the galvanized screws. We don't have to worry about the black ones. Okay, so taking our T25 Torx screwdriver, and removing the galvanized bolts. You don't have to worry about the black ones. Okay, one more on the far passenger side. And it looks like our screwdriver is not going to be able to get in there. So I'm going to go ahead and use a ratchet with the Torx bit on it. Just shortens things up a little bit. Okay, this is the toughest one because there's not a lot of room in there to get this out. But once you do, it'll make the installation a lot easier. You'll have a lot more room. And so now that we've got that last screw out, push forward and then maneuver around here and just pull right out. Just like that. Okay, now that we have the passenger side trim out of the bumper here, we're gonna go ahead and do the exact same thing on the driver's side. Okay, so I've got all four screws taken out of the exhaust trim here. Take this guy out on the driver's side, set it down. I'm gonna grab the hitch and I'm just gonna put it up in place. Mark out the heat shield. This will make sure it lines up properly. So today I'm using a U-Haul exclusive hitch jack. If you don't have one of these, you'll need a set of hands from a neighbor or friend. Okay. Now we can go ahead and take the hitch out again and we'll go ahead and trim that heat shield up. Okay, we've got our heat shield marked up. I'm going to go ahead and lower it using a ratchet and 10 millimeter socket. And it's just going to require removing two nuts, one here, one here. I'm just going to pull straight down. That gives us enough room to get our shears in here and make our cut. I'm going to be going right down the inside of the driver's side front, or passenger side frame here. It's going to go just past this hole in the heat shield. You can see putting the hitch up in place helped me out with making my marks here, seeing exactly where the hitch is going to be sitting on the frame. Be real careful about any sharp edges so you don't cut yourself. Okay, now that we have this side cut out, go ahead and put our nuts back into place. Okay, we'll go ahead and do the exact same thing on the driver's side. Okay, we made our cut just like we did on the passenger side. Now we'll take our nuts, put them back into place. Bottom of the frame and then one on the side of the trunk pan. Okay, we've got our heat shield cut and put back into place. We're gonna use our exact same 10 millimeter socket that we're using to tighten down the heat shield, and we're gonna take out these bumper bolts on the inside of the bumper. They're not real tight, come out real easy. Okay, one more at the top. Okay, we'll go ahead and do the exact same thing on the passenger side. Okay, now that we have our bumper bolts out of place, we're gonna go ahead and put our frame bolts in. These come with the hitch, so we're gonna be using a 7/16 carriage bolt, 7/16 washer or plate. And we're also gonna use the provided fish wire here. It just screws right into the threads on the carriage bolt. Just like that. Now our next step is just to push it inside the existing hole in the frame. This is the hole we're going to be going in and then pulling straight back down through. To do that, we'll separate the bolt from the plate. Push the bolt inside the frame. Push the plate inside the frame. Pull straight back. Then we'll go ahead and leave the fish wire on the bolt. We'll go ahead and do the same thing on the passenger side. Push the bolt through, and the plate through, and just straight back down. We'll go ahead and leave the wire hanging there. Now the next step is just put the hitch in place. Go ahead and grab this hitch here. Okay, we have the vehicle prepped up for the hitch to go into place now. Have all of our hardware in place, bumper bolts taken out. We're just gonna prop the hitch up there. Once we get it close, I'll pull those fish wires through the attachment hole on the hitch. Okay, now that our hitch is in place, I got a perfect view of exactly how the hitch is going to be mounted. You can see that the two bumper bolts here and here are going to be mounting to the hitch here and here. And then we've got a frame bolt that we've already fish wired through the frame here. I'll go ahead and start by bringing the wire through the hitch so that as I raise it into position, you don't lose the hardware in the frame. Leave that just like that, and I'll go ahead and do the passenger side. Just Okay, now I can go ahead and raise the hitch all the way into position. Basically what I'm doing by all the cranking is leveling the hitch out. And the bolts came right through the bottom of the hitch here. Got our conical washer and our nut. Make sure that on the conical washer it has the teeth. The teeth will be contacting the hitch. We'll put that up first. We'll put our nut in place. Okay, we've got that guy secured. Now we'll go ahead and take our two bumper bolts that we took out earlier. We'll go ahead and screw those back in. Go through the hitch. Right into the existing lug nut. We'll get that one started. We'll go ahead and put the other one in. Take out our fish wire here. Washer first with our teeth up, contacting the hitch, then the nut. Okay, then we'll go ahead and put our bumper bolts back in place. Okay, now that I've got those started, I'll go ahead and grab a 10 millimeter socket and snug them up, and then we'll get them torqued down. Out of our way. Okay, back on the passenger side, snugging up the bumper bolts. 10 millimeter socket. Okay, our bumper bolts are all snug. I'm gonna grab my torque wrench. We're gonna be using the same 10 millimeter socket. We're gonna set our torque wrench to 27 foot pounds. Okay. We'll go ahead and torque them down to spec. This fascia is pretty flexible, so I can pull it back and get my torque wrench into position here. The deep socket 10 millimeter. Every torque wrench is going to give you an indication when it's reaches torque. This one is going to get a snap or a pop, just like that. We'll get the top bolt. There it is. Go ahead and get the driver's side torqued in. There it is. There it is. Okay, now for the 7/16 bolts on the frame, I'm gonna switch over to 11/16 deep socket. And we are going to reset our torque wrench to 50 foot pounds. Okay, let's go ahead and tie it, open down. This. Okay. Go ahead and get the side one done. Okay, our hitch is torqued down and it's in place. Now we're gonna go ahead and hang the exhaust back up. We'll start on the passenger side. Just gonna lift. See, it lines right up with the exhaust hanger hole. Push it right into place. Go ahead and move over to the driver's side. The same thing on the furthest one back here. Okay, now we'll move to the most forward hanger. The exhaust hung back up. We need to put our chrome trim panels back into place. Okay, we got this guy set. It was a little bit difficult because the hitch now is in place. It doesn't leave a lot of room for your hands to get in there and tools, but be patient. You'll get it. Okay, so I did have to switch over to a ratchet wrench with a quarter inch socket and T25 Torx bit just to shorten things up a little bit. We are working with a small space here. Now that we've got the exhaust trim done on the driver's side, we'll move over and do it on the passenger side. And put this guy on here, get the holes lined up. Now we're going to take our ratchet here and get into this tight space. Got our exhaust trim back into place into the fascia. Our next step is going to be installing the underbody paneling here. I'll grab it here to show what it looks like. Basically it goes back into place just like this, but as you can see the hitch is in the way. So we're going to have to mark this out, trim it, then get it back into place and then put the screws back in here. Getting this underbody panel trimmed, I'm going to be using this screw hole and this screw hole to center me up with the hitch. So I'll just take a measurement from here to there and here to this part of the hitch from the bottom of the bumper here. And then we'll mark that on our underbody paneling. So from the hitch to the first hole, we're looking at 2.5 strong. From the hitch to the driver's side hole, we're looking at 2.5. So we'll just call it 2.5. Okay, now let's go ahead and make our marks on the body paneling. We're just going to go 2.5 on each side of the hole. Okay, that'll be our center point. And now from the back of the hitch, the front hole, looks like we've got about 2 inches. We'll take off a quarter for the plate. So from the edge of this curve here down, we're gonna go into 3/4. Just kind of run it down. And we'll just make a straight line. Okay, we're ready to cut. I'm using an air saw to make my cuts today. Okay, so we made our center cut to spec. Everything worked out well here. And then we tried a few times to get it up into place, and we now understand why the instructions say that additional trimming may be required, is because this portion of the underbody paneling hits the actual bracket here on the hitch on both sides. So we did have to make a cut both sides here and here so it would slide past that. We got it into place and realized that we need to take about an inch, or about a quarter of an inch off, a little bit more here. So that's what I'm going to do now, and then I'll put it right back into place. Now that I've got it into place, I'm going to need to pull the fascia back a little bit so that it goes over this lip. Okay, now we're just making sure that all of our holes are lining up properly. Okay, perfect. And this still has to go up. So these tabs here go on the inside of this heat shield. Same on this one. So what you're gonna have to do is just bend this heat shield down. Don't be afraid to move it and bend it out of the way. It'll bend right back into place. Put that over the existing stud on the passenger side and on the driver's side. And then on the driver's side, we had our locking washer here. We're just going to spin that back on. Let's get in those pliers and push it in place. Just push and spin. Perfect. Now we can bend our heat shield back into place. Okay, then we're gonna take our heat shield nut. Just gotta get it started here. Okay, now we'll take our 10 millimeter socket, and tighten them down. Okay, then we have our 10 racer screws that go along the bottom here. We'll go ahead and get those into place as well. Okay, so we're on our last lower fascia screw. Just to get it hand tight, snug up there. Okay, that's our hitch for the Lincoln Continental. You can see that we have the 1¼-inch receiver tube here. The cross tube is well hidden. It's got your safety chain loops here and a 1/2-inch pin and clip hole. This hitch is rated for 3,500 pounds trailer weight, 300 pounds tongue weight. And that's gonna be it for our hitch for the Lincoln Continental. Have fun, be safe. Thanks for watching our video, thank you.
To learn more about the products seen in this video, or to schedule an installation by a U-Haul Hitch Professional, visit us online today at uhaulhitches.com.